Okay, let's move on, and now we're going to talk about HTTP. If you recall, this was what we described as the main protocol of the web. This is what your browser uses to talk to the web servers. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. The request from your browser for the URL www.example.com/foo begins with a request line. It looks something like this. This is the request line. Now, HTTP is a very simple text protocol. So this text is sent over the internet to the server, just like this. It's human readable too. The request line has three main parts. First is the method. Next is the path. And finally is the version. The method is what type of request you're making to the server. The most common method by far is GET. And this is how you get a document from the server. Other popular methods are GET and POST. There are other ones, but these are the ones we're going to use in the class. Next is the path. In this case, it's slash foo. You remember this from the URL, that the path from the URL comes here. This is the actual document we're requesting from the server. And finally is the version. It's always HTTP slash and then a version number. Most browsers and servers these days speak 1.1, but we'll also touch on 1.0 a little bit in this class, because 1.0 has a few uses of its own. Now, you're wondering where the host name is in this request line? It's not here. All that's here is the path. We're connected to this host. Your browser connected to this host, or if we're playing around with HTTP, we made the connection. But that's how we know where we are. So this is used for making the connection, and the path is used for making the request. Let's have a quick quiz. Given the following URL, example.com/foo/logo.png, *p=1#tricky, what is the request line to get this URL using HTTP 1.1?